Now we'll start the topic of rectilinear motion. Rectilinear motion can be directly written as motion of a body along a straight line. When a body moves along a straight line, either forward or backward, in either direction, when a body moves along a straight line, this motion we simply call as rectilinear motion. And in case of rectilinear motion, as body moves only along one dimension of a coordinate system, we can simply write it motion in one dimension. So, motion along a straight line can be either termed as rectilinear motion or motion in one dimension. Before proceeding further in motion in one dimension or motion in 1D, you must understand one thing very carefully, that is reference frame. The concept of reference frame itself is very important to understand. Almost in all problems of mechanics, which we will study further, reference frame is simply, you can simply say it is a region or a zone from where observations are taken for motion parameters of a body. When we talk about observations for motion parameters of a body, when a body moves, with the motion of a body, the parameters which are associated are simply, we can say, displacement, velocity, acceleration, time, parameters associated with the motion of a body. The region from where all these observations are taken, we define as a reference frame. Reference frame, it can be at rest or maybe in motion, maybe moving. Like for example, if you are standing on ground, say for example you are standing on ground and you are looking onto a body which is moving at a speed of 10 meters per second, then in your reference frame or with respect to ground, we can say the body is moving at 10 meters per second. But the same body when observed by a boy who is say standing on a skateboard which is moving at some other velocity, say 10 meters per second, then we can say this boy who is moving at a speed 10 meters per second, he'll feel that this body X is at rest. Because both of these are moving at a speed 10 meters per second. So we can say this boy will not observe any motion in this body. So in the reference frame of observer A, this body is moving at 10 meters per second, and in the reference frame of observer B, this body is at rest. So reference frame we can simply define as a region or zone from where observations are taken for motion parameters of a body. And either of these parameters can be recorded when a moving body is observed from a given reference frame. If we take up another example to understand the concept of reference frame, say we are having a car which is moving at a speed of 3 meters per second and a boy who is standing at rest on ground. So we can say the reference frame of this observer is ground. Here we can say reference frame is ground because he is measuring the motion parameters of this car from ground. Now, if we consider another observer who is moving on a trolley like this, say this is observer A and this observer B, who is on a trolley which is moving at a speed of 1 meters per second. So here we can simply call reference frame is trolley. Now, from this trolley, this observer B is measuring the motion of car. So here we can say speed of car with respect to ground frame is, simply we can call velocity of car as measured from ground frame is 3 meters per second. And here if we measure speed of car with respect to reference frame of trolley. In this situation, velocity of car as measured by the observer B can be written as car is moving at 3 meters per second, and this trolley is moving at 1 meters per second. In 1 second, it will travel a distance 1 meter. In 1 second, it will travel a distance 3 meter. So, as seen by this observer, it has progressed the distance of 2 meter in 1 second. So, we can say its velocity is 2 meters per second. So, we can see with respect to various frames of observation, the motion parameters, like here we are observing velocity of this car, the motion parameters measured are different. So, we can simply state a reference frame is a coordinate system with a clock, as all motion parameters are related to time, for measurement of time. A coordinate system with a clock for measurement of time. It may be at rest, on ground, or may be attached to a moving body or observer. This is the basic definition for a reference frame. We'll just go through all the things once again, because reference frame itself is a very important concept, because all problems which we are going to face in the chapter of motion in one dimension, motion in two dimension, or any other topic of mechanics, these are all related to reference frames. Now we'll study about various kind of motion parameters associated with the motion of a body. The very first is distance and displacement. I hope in your earlier classes you have covered the basic difference between distance and displacement in motion of a body. So, a body starts from point A, and along with this path the body goes to point B. This is the path along which the body is moving. So, the length of this path we simply call as distance. We just talk about distance covered. This can be written as path length. If we just talk about the term displacement, it is the shortest distance between point A and point B. This point A to B we call a displacement vector, because displacement is a vector quantity. When we talk about displacement, it is simply the straight line length A to B. This AB vector is the displacement vector which is associated with the body. Now, say for one dimensional motion, when we talk in case of a rectilinear motion, when a body moves along a straight line, say it is possible that from a point O a body starts, it moves in forward direction, at some point A it will come to rest, and then it will return back on the same line and reaches a point B. So, here we can simply state, when we talk about the distance covered by the body, so this distance we can write as OAB. It goes from O to A, then A to B, the total distance will be OAB. But when we talk about its displacement, this displacement can be written as OB vector. It is directly from a starting point to the end point. This is the vector OB, which we call as displacement vector. Now, the second point, if we talk about the motion parameters, that is speed and velocity. Speed and velocity are exactly related to the phenomena which we have studied in distance and displacement. When we talk about the speed, it is a scalar quantity and it is measured by calculating the distance traveled by the body in a given time duration. And velocity is a vector quantity which gives or which is measured by calculating the displacement covered by the body in a given duration. So if we talk just about speed, you can simply call it, it is rate of change of position of body, and here we measure only the magnitude. But when we talk about velocity, velocity is also given as the rate of change of position. But in case of velocity, we must mention the magnitude as well as direction. Without direction, the velocity will be incomplete information. It will just be the magnitude of velocity, which can be written as speed. And speed and velocity, these can be defined in various ways. Let's see that in detail. Let us discuss the concept of average speed and average velocity. When a particle moves, average speed in a given motion can be written as total distance traveled divided by time taken. Similarly, we can also define average velocity. For a particle's motion, average velocity can be written as total displacement divided by time taken. If particle is moving in a single direction, then there won't be any difference in average speed and average velocity. Like for example, a particle starts from point A, goes to a point B situated at a distance L. And say at time t1 it was at position A and at time t2 it was at position B. Then average speed in going from A to B can be simply written as L by t2 minus t1. And the same will be the average velocity. There won't be any difference in average speed and average velocity. But say in a one dimensional motion situation is like this, that a particle starts from A, goes to a point B located at a distance L1, and then it comes back to a point C by traveling a reverse distance L2. And say it was at position A at time t1 and at C at time t2. In this situation, if we talk about average speed we write as L1 plus L2 by t2 minus t1. Because in moving from point A to C, the total distance covered will be L1 plus L2 and the time taken is t2 minus t1. And here if we calculate the average velocity can be written as the displacement upon time. So your displacement will be L1 minus L2 and the time will remain same, that is t2 minus t1. This is the basic difference between average speed and average velocity. In average velocity, we must also mention the direction in which it is moving. Like here it is moving from A to C. This is say the direction towards east. So we can simply state in this direction, this is the average velocity which is given in vector form, where we can write this delta L vector which is from A to C divided by delta T. Or we must write the magnitude and the direction which is toward east or along positive x-axis.